September. Someone's always got to go.
Somebody's always got to go. That's the best bit, isn't it?
As we were saying before, it's what you get into boxing. It's what it's all about, isn't it, mate?
But it's a fight you can get up for. It's an exciting fight. Instead of these routine fights, you're like, oh, routine fight. At least the fans, I've got so much to look forward to them, you know what I mean? Getting tickets out there is a lot easier.
You know, that's part of your apprenticeship. You've got to find those people to get you to this level, to prepare you for it.
Definitely.
But these done the same as you. These beat all the usual suspects. You beat all the usual suspects.
Yeah.
But suddenly, normally, there's a transition point where you might fight someone with maybe a 50-50 record.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's a little test to see if you're ready for the next level.
Which is,
you bypass that, both of you.
Yeah, it's like going straight 100% record. It's like we've gone. You know what I mean? Just straight up there.
Well, you know, that's like I say, that's the exciting part about it. You've both gone to two unbeaten fighters, and really, you know, he's going to jump on your shoulders, or you're going to jump on his shoulders to get to that next level. In fact, it might be actually two levels you're going to jump above, because if you win this fight, then suddenly, you know, the opportunities for perhaps, you know, even an English title
Definitely.
Won't be too far away.
Definitely. Either way, whoever comes through this fight, there's massive opportunities after this fight for the next person.
I just think, you know, it's going to have to happen a little bit more often, this.
Yeah.
You know, people taking a risk. And it's a big risk, but it's a great one. And not only that, on the same show, you've got two other lads having a little bit of a step up, and they're challenging for titles as well.
So who's on that? Is it Ben Sheedy?
Ben Sheedy.
And McCall and McGowan?
Yeah. Well, Ben Sheedy's been getting better with every fight.
Yeah, Ben Sheedy.
McGowan. I think he's only took a couple of risks, but he's done it away from home. He went over and fought at Jess Smith where he got a draw. And he went down south to beat a kid down there who was unbeaten at the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, he stepped up a little time, but he needs to build his fan base now in Manchester to help him get to the next level.
They're both quality fighters. I know. Remember Ben Sheedy? He used to box for John Hart. Is it John Hart?
Yes, he did.
Yeah, John Hart did both.
I think he won the under novices, under 10, under 20s.
Yeah, I've seen bits of him as a pro now.
He got to the finals. But he's been getting better with every single fight. And I think last time out at Victoria Warehouse, he had an absolute. Because his coach is Enzo Bingham. And he did a beautiful left up to take the kid's head off. I think it was Luke Gallen, I think his name was. A big Southpaw kid, and he ripped his head off. It was beautiful, absolutely cracking.
Didn't see that. He's a very good boxer. And McGowan, he's very game. He's coming forward. He's very strong as well.
If he gets down to welterweight, like we're talking about, he could be right in the mix there within a couple of fights.
Yeah, definitely.
So it's a cracking night for everyone to get down there. But let's talk more about yourself, because as we were saying, you know, you're a very unusual style out there.
Yeah.
You're dancing there, mate.
Everybody who was sparring in the gym's like, you can't read you. You've got different pace jams, you've got different pace sets, you don't know what's going on. But, you know what I mean? I mean, people, until you spar me, I just look just like a normal, awkward person. But until you're in there, you're like, really, like, this is really awkward.
Are you
Manchester
to
Masher?
With finesse, hopefully.
probably about the fitness. But yeah, I've been doing a lot of sparring with Masher.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's been helping me fitness a lot. Masher and Lee Quinn.
Yeah.
They got the boys from Birkenhead.
Yeah, well, I know you've got a good connection because Damon Jones used to manage him, who works for you now.
Yeah.
So, it's exciting times. And what have you got? Last start of the week now, is it?
Last start of the week now, got 8 rounds of sparring now. and then tomorrow I've got my strength and conditioning, and then another probably 8 to 10 rounds Friday.
But your job keeps you fairly fit anyway, because you're one of those crazy men that when they can't get access to
an upseller.
When you can't get access to certain parts of the buildings, you get the ropes out and you
sit down there and keeps you fit. I mean, you're constantly pulling up 200 meter ropes all day, which is it's really heavy. That gets really heavy, but obviously it's good conditioning for you.
Well, it does, doesn't it? It gives you conditioning that. You know, if you watched some of the videos that Hugh Fury and Peter Fury has been putting out,
in the woods, and the chopping the hammers.
That's what you're doing all day.
It's best
exercise all day that keeps you.
Yeah.
You know, without having to train, you've got an extra 10 miles in the bank every day just by doing what you do at work.
Exactly. It's like sometimes there's times where I can't make training, which has been quite often like. Also, my job keeps me fit anyway, so I'm not too concerned, because I'm constantly, as I say, pulling up 200 meter rolls, so I'm constantly moving 25 kilo weights all day.
Well,
and climbing. So
I'm going to ask you now, because I think I asked Bill earlier, I just spoke to him a couple of days ago, what's the move around Jack Catchrow and the good young amateur who's just turning over, who's making his pro debut on the same night that you two fight, that's Kane Gardner.
Kane Gardner, yeah.
And
he's with Ian, is it Ian?
Yeah, Ian Harrison and Tommy Backle.
Yeah.
And cracking lads.
Yeah, he's pretty slick himself, isn't he? He's a good mover.
Well, very good amateur. Northwest champion on several occasions, got to the quarterfinals, I think, of the Nationals, and he got to the semi-final. I think we ranked number four at one point in England. So
yeah, I've not seen much Kane box anyway, but I've heard his name pop quite a few times.
Yeah.
So you don't hear that. Go on then.
Any predictions?
Not really. I'm not one to speak out. You know what I mean? Because we've both got two arms, we've got two legs, and we both can punch. You know what I mean? So it's just one of them. Everyone's got a punching chance.
But is the belt coming back in?
Hopefully, you're not getting too much out of the league. But yeah, I just like I said, just thought the best one wins on that, and each one of us goes home safe, and that's about it for me.
Well, listen, I know you're going to be in for a good night. Just for the ticket money alone, just for your two, you and Bill are fighting one another. For me, I know it's going to deliver, because VIP fighters never fail.
Yeah, definitely.
Put them against one another, and something special happens.
It'll definitely be a good show, so everybody that's not got a ticket, get a ticket, because obviously you'll not get another show like this for £35.
No, definitely. All right.
Thank you very much, Lee. Cheers, pal.
Catch you soon. Bye.
Nice one.